We will assess the quality controls with Ssdwlab 6. The first quality control that we are going to analyze is the percentage of positive cases, PCP. We go to the main screen and we access to menu called Tools. We choose the submenu Quality Controls, specifically, the option Percentage of Positive Cases. It will appear a screen that in the left side we can observe different controls. We can select the profile which analyzes the percentage of positive cases. In this case, for all screening profiles, we can define if the cases have been validated or not. If we analyze only trisomy 21, or all the trisomies, also we can choose only singleton pregnancies, twins only, or all pregnancies, the cutoff level for example 250. The interval of the dates that we will assess the percentage of positive cases. In this case we are modifying the dates, minimum data screening and maximum data screening. And we execute the query, which can be automated, in the right side of the screen. The percentage of positive cases is presented, as we see globally is around 4.8%. We can observe the PCP month by month, and furthermore, these data can be presented in a PDF type report. We can export the data in different formats as Excel, text or others. The report that is presented on screen is what will appear in the printed version. Now let's see how to assess the median of multiple of median in their temporal trends. We return to the initial screen, we select Tools menu, Quality Control, Median MOM and the temporal trends. We can notice that in the left side of the screen there is control panel. We can define the date interval, the profile that we will analyze, the marker. In this case may be pregnancy-associated plasma protein A. We can also assess by number of fetuses. All these controls are very intuitive. Once we have selected the controls, we execute the query. In the screen is presented the median of multiple of the median corresponding to pregnancy-associated plasma protein A. We see that the median corrected MOM is 1.021 and the median uncorrected MOM is 1.004. They lie between 0.9 and 1.1, which corresponds to 10% of the value of 1. We can analyze another marker, such nuchal translucency, or free beta-chorionic gonadotropin. As will be in this case, the median corrected MOM is 1.067, and the median uncorrected MOM is 1.056. We note that in September the medians, both corrected and uncorrected, were at the limit of their acceptable interval. The median of multiple of the median can be analyzed for different gestational ages, or different weeks of gestation, or in the case of the nuchal translucency by different lengths of the fetus. In the main screen, we select the Tools menu, Quality Control, Median Multiples of the Median and the option by gestational age. The controls are very similar to the previous option. We define the selection, for example, all cases, validated or not, the profile which we will take data. In this case a first trimester combined screening profile, also we select the marker, such as chorionic gonadotropin, we choose a single fetus. We click execute query and automatically the median of multiple of median by gestational ages is presented. We observe that the median corrected MOM is 1.067 and the uncorrected median MOM is 1.056. If we execute the query for Papa, we see that both median MOM, corrected and uncorrected, are inside the limits for each gestational week. And for nuchal translucency, the median MOM value is 0.939. We observe at the bottom of the graph that the gestational age is measured in fetal length, CRL, by millimeters intervals. We see that approximately all are in the range of the 10% of 1. Now we analyze the median of multiple of the median by maternal weight. We do the same. We go back to the Tools menu, and we select the option Quality Controls. median mom by maternal weight, it appears on the left side of the screen. The parameters that will define our query, profile, marker, etc. We do our selection as in all previous cases. Once we introduce these parameters, we execute the query. For example, in this case it appears on the screen the median of multiples of the median for Papa by different weight ranges. We can observe the corrected and the uncorrected medians. The median corrected mom is 1.021, and the median uncorrected mom is 1.004 for all weights intervals. But we can note that in the weights interval less than 50 kilograms, the median uncorrected mom is outside the limits, we are overestimating. And the median mom corrected by weight and other factors tends to correct but still is out the limits. For weight intervals above 70 kilograms, the median uncorrected mom is outside the limits, but now is underestimating. However, median corrected mom value is inside the acceptable range. If we assess the median mom for free beta, we can observe that in low weights the median uncorrected mom is off the limits, overestimating its value. And for high weights the median uncorrected mom is also outside the acceptable range. In its case we are underestimating, but we can observe that the corrections works. Because the median mom corrected by maternal weight and others factors are inside the appropriate range. Naturally, our program allows calculating these corrections automatically. And finally, we will analyze the CUSUM, the cumulative sum of the deviations from the obtained value regarding the expected value. CUSUM is a very important quality control to the ultrasound measurements, specifically for the nuchal translucency, because it allows us to assess very reliable manner the quality with which these data are obtained from different sonographers. We select the submenu CUSUM ultrasound from the quality controls submenu. We select the interval of dates, the screening profile, the ultrasound center, the marker that in this case is nuchal translucency, the number of fetuses, and then we execute the query. We can observe that every sonographer involved in the nuchal translucency's measurement has his own color. We see that the sonographer 6, in purple color, tends to underestimate the value of nuchal translucency. We can note that as the number of screenings increases, it goes out of bounds. If we examine other ultrasound center, like Echo Center 8, we can observe that the sonographer 7 tends to overestimating the value of nuchal translucency. As the number of screening increases, it goes out of the upper bound. Overestimating and underestimating are relatively common ultrasound errors when measuring the nuchal translucency, and CUSUM let us detect these errors. But we need 40 or 50 scans to detect if a sonographer is outside the range. We can calculate the CUSUM for biochemical markers. It will give us an idea of how the laboratories are measuring the biochemical markers. We go to the appropriate menu, and then we define our query. For example, we choose a first trimester screening profile, single gestation only, trisomy 21. And the marker will be pregnancy-associated plasma protein A. We execute the query, and we see that is quite good, as they are almost all the time within proper limits. We have seen some quality controls that will help us to assess the screenings.